Hi everybody, Alfie here. The reason I want to make this video is because that I wanted at first I wanted to be a true vlogger because there's a lot of things that I need to talk about to people that I'm also a counselor. I am not a certified counselor, but that's one of my passion to help people because of what I've been through, right, in life. I've been seeing a psychiatrist, psychologist for almost 12 years, if not more, and I've learned a lot from them eventually once I found the the way, or maybe the reasons. So I found the reason, and I don't think that the reason fit me here in Malaysia, so I think I might go abroad. So the reason I want to be here is that this is 2017, right? So at first I want to be a true vlogger. I wanted to be a really, really firm and happening and happy vlogger that vlog about anything, everything, what I experienced, what I went through to help other people. For example, like if I receive bad services from people from this company or that company, they're making things bad and stuff like that. But eventually I noticed that I was a model, right? I was a model. When I in my 20s, I'm now 30. I'm going to be 38 this 19 February. So what I noticed was that I'm fat right now. Okay, let's not. I'm not gonna sugarcoat anything. This is double language. I'm gonna speak bilanguage like Malay and English. So do last time I was really skinny. I'm 5'9", and I'm wearing 24 size jeans, and I'm really, really skinny. And I was a model, and my skin was great. And then kulit kita cantik. I mean, kulit I memang really, really cantik. And ramai orang geram tengok my skin, and they love my skin. And then it's really hard for me to find a job. I graduated from Lim Kok Wing, holding a diploma in advertising, multimedia, and broadcasting. But it's really hard for me to find a job because of my gender. I am a transsexual. Diagnosed. Actually, I'm diagnosed with hermaphrodite. With doctor, I have a letter, which I'm not going to talk about that tonight. What I'm going to talk about is I don't want to be depressed anymore. I don't want to be sad. I don't want to be, there is no time. Time runs, I mean, like the wind, as fast as the wind. So I don't think that I want to be sad forever. I'm trying to battle with it. That battle with my depression. I want to be strong. I want to do a comeback. Okay, I've been skinny and fat and skinny and fat again and again. So now I know the reason how now, what should I do and stuff like that, right? So now 2017, I want you guys to challenge me, and I want to challenge you guys 2017 to be the best. To make the best out of ourself, love ourself more, and to make the best out of ourself, and to reach our dreams and goals in life. Find ourselves first. If you guys are di antara umur 19 years old, you just maybe okay now. For example, you just finished high school. In Malaysia, we call it after SPM. That we're in high school, right? Finish SPM, and what should I do? What course should I take? So you really have to look deep inside your soul and think, okay, I want to be this because I want. What do you want? Okay, what do you achieve from that? Will it make you happy? Number one, think about the future after you receive the degree or diploma or PhD or whatever you want to be, the one thing that you chose because. When you choose something, when you say yes to something, this is what I learned, that you have to be committed to it, that you have to be, you kind of like taking oath. When you say yes to something, you have to give 100%, 1,000%, doing it. For example, if you want to be a doctor, not because of the money, not because of the pangkat or the, whatever, it's because of you want to be a doctor. You're passionate to be a doctor. You love to treat people. You love to help people. You have inside of your heart that you want to make a change. You want to make a difference. You want this and that. You want to be whatever you want to be, a teacher. But please remember this, pada yang siapa yang ambil SPM, first of all, dekat Malaysia ni, and I'm speaking in Malay now because I'm talking to my Malaysian audience. Dekat Malaysia ni, kadang-kadang kita ikut cakap mak bapak, memang sama-sama tak nak buat apa. Macam, but the thing is, choose the right course you want to take, and then think about the consequences after you receive your PhD. When you are a doctor, when you became a doctor, when you start to become a doctor, for example, if you choose to be a doctor or a teacher, what are the consequences? Can you handle the consequences? Boleh tak you hadapi risk, the risk? Yes, you might be a doctor, but then, can you handle the patient punya karenah? Like, can you handle the patients? Can you be patient with the patient? Kalau jadi cikgu, if you want to be a teacher, boleh tak handle? Can you handle the students this and that, this and that? Or maybe you want to be. Okay, personally, I realize that too long. I'm not saying that it's too late for me. I can still pursue my dream to be a psychologist. But I should have, would have, could have done it earlier rather than taking the wrong course. Because I love practical, actually practical, you can work anywhere if you know something. But I can do practical stuff like cooking and, I mean, food is always good because it will, food is always good if you, I mean, to have a side income. Like cake, food, but make sure it's really, really delicious, okay? And then, now, please think the consequences before you take the but take the whatever you want to be. Because I don't want to hear. Who am I? Okay, but I mean, I don't like okay to hear that. Be careful what you wish for, cause you just might get it. Macam you nak jadi doctor, tapi you tak boleh, you cannot handle patient. Once you want to be a doctor, but then you complain, you say this and that and this and that. So I don't want to hear that. Like you got the all the money, like me, I have to struggle to find the money to get money because it's because of my gender. I mean, I took advertising, multimedia, and broadcasting, and why should my gender be such an issue in that industry? Because I was a model, so I know how it works. But why is it such an issue that there was one company said that Alfie, and I won the Best in Presentation Skill Award, and there was this company said that Alfie, if you are not in Malaysia, you'll be great. And there's another company said that, sorry, Alfie, we can't take you. Because you might ruin our company's name. Okay? So, you know what? I had enough because I don't have money. My sister, we're not doing well anymore. We used to be doing very, my mom and dad used to be doing very, very well. And now I'm the only child yang who is not contributing to anything. I feel hopeless, useless, worthless, which contribute more towards my depression and it. My illness. So, you know what? And then, okay, the reason why, let's start what I want to talk about tonight. Now, tonight, today, okay? This is what the point is. The point is, let 2017 be the best. Let's make ourselves the best out of 2017. For example, you just finished school. Think. Do not jump into straight away make, you know, you want money, or you think that being a doctor make a lot of money, being a lawyer and being this make a lot of money. Don't think about that. Think about the passion, because I promise you that at the end of the day, your happiness is what count. What really make count. I mean, I have met one journalist, and I wanted to be a journalist that at that moment, and I was like, oh my god, you're a journalist, that's so great. And I was in this NGO company, and I asked, I asked him, and then, what do you, oh my god, what's your next, what you going to do next? And then, guess what he said? He said that, I want to be a farmer. At the end of the day, he's tired of the city, maybe, I don't know. But that's what he said to me. So I said, oh, okay. So it was an awkward moment. So please remember that. Okay, now, if you baru lepas SPM, baru lepas habis sekolah, and then you just finish school, say you really want to be a lawyer. You know the consequences. You know how the risks and the headaches is going to be. And you said, I can do this because I'm passionate to do this. And I think I'm a good debater. I think I can win this. I'm a go-getter in a sense of law. And I love law, and I love history, and I love this and that. Okay, so you make a decision. So 2017, what you should do is take it and then go for the college, go for the class, and ace for it, you know, nail it, Dean's list. And if you're in your 20s and if you already have a job, okay, now, that is all outside. Now, I want to challenge this. Let's do it from the inside and outside. Regardless who you are, or whether you are so rich, or you reach your dream as this is what I come to a conclusion. In this world, three things is the most important thing for a woman. For a guy, maybe two or three, or same three, I don't know. Okay, first, you have to have the brain. Number two, you have to have the looks. Okay, brain goes to the heart as well. You have to have a very good insight, very good heart, and it will create the positive energy inside you and attract the positive energy towards you. And you have to look good inside out. I am not happy with the way I look now today. I am not happy at all the way I look. I am fat. I'm not taking care of myself. I'm not taking care of my skin. I'm not happy at all with in my state right now. Number three is money, maybe. You have to have brains, looks, and money. I think that one is for guys. And girls, you have to have good brains and heart. And for ladies, you have to be intelligent. You know how to hold. It may be a man's world, but the woman... Oh, the world is a man's world, but the women control the man. Not to say man or woman or lover. Okay, that's how I call it. Maybe you're gay or bisexual or whatever, but the one you love controls the world. That's the right word. Sorry. Love controls the world. And please, no more haters, please. Because you know what? Why hate when loving is so easy? Loving is so happy, and it attracts positive energy. It shows the beauty in you regardless whatever you look like. And just no hate. Okay, just don't be a haters. Okay, now, for example, me. Now, let's talk about me and whoever can relate to my situation right now. I'm not happy with my body. I'm not happy with my looks, my skin, my hair. My soul is kind of broken, but it's kind of like coming back for me to move on to achieve what I want. So I thought I want to be a vlogger. A vlogger. I have my blog. I have a stupid vlog before this. I wasn't ready. I didn't. I just went through it, right? It was horrible. So I realized that, oh my God, I mean, what is the point of being? I have so little money, and with that amount of money, I want to buy the lightings, I want to buy the a little active camera, like GoPro, something like that, and then I want to buy a lot of camera thingy to vlog things. Luckily that I have this tripod. I'm so happy with my tripod right now. And suddenly it snaps me. What's the point of being a vlogger when you hate looking yourself in the camera? You hate the way you look. I am not happy because that's what I want, because I used to it. I'm not saying that I was pretty, but people told me that, and that's what I thought. And then I kind of like, after a while, when people keep on saying it, I was modeling, and I was kind of like doing a lot of modeling, a lot of walking, a lot of, not to say a lot of TVC, I don't do much, a lot of TVC, but a lot of walking. And people take picture of me here and there, and I'm used to that. And suddenly when I lost a job, and then they lied to me, and then I lost the case in the court. I stayed home. I ate. I start to take sugar. I start to pam. I just like a lazy cat, kucing malas yang duduk kat rumah macam. I don't even eat much, but I ate the wrong things like processed food, sugar, and stuff like that. So what I want to do is I switch all those things that I want to buy, like the camera, like the lighting, like this and that. I want to keep all that first. What I want to do now is I want to invest all the money with my looks. And okay, this is me talking. Whoever can relate, or people who wanted to, you can relate this story to whatever you want to achieve, okay? Apa-apa you nak jadi pun, you boleh relate dengan I punya story kat sini, okay? Macam, okay, now, I'm not happy with that because I am not happy in Malaysia. I want to go abroad. I'm not going to migrate. I might just work abroad because, yeah, even I went for interview, he asked me to go outside Malaysia. So, I want to make the best out of myself. And then, I'm not going to tell the product that I bought. I invest, as you can see at the back there, it's a hint. I'm not going to show you guys. It's a hint what I use. I only will show you when the result is here. You know, I don't like people to say, ah, there you go again. That's what you said 5 years ago. You want to lose weight, and da, da, da. I don't want to hear that. So what I'm trying to hear, I want to challenge you guys, and you guys challenge me by the end of the year. November, not December, November, that I am progressing. You know, whenever I buy something or I start to eat something like supplements and buy something for the hair or the face, and I know that I have the award, best in presentation skill, I got my diploma, I'm a bright person, I know that. I'm an A student, I know that I can achieve my dream. But first of all, I remember that beauty holds something, you know. I kind of like ex I have I drove a car and I accidentally hit a car, another car, and the car went out, and there was this guy with bald head wanted to punch me in the face. And when he opened the door, and he was like, he saw me, and he's like, oh, a girl, a hottie, you know. And I was like, it changes a person perception, and I get a lot of attention. So being beautiful, cantik, dalam dan luar, okay? Bukan cantik dekat luar je, okay? Cantik kat luar memang tak guna. Serious. If you are beautiful and you're snob, just get out of my life. Do not look at me. Do not, you're not even, oh my God, please. I met a lot of person who are like that. But you have to be beautiful inside out. Okay, now I'm not going to tell you product apa, but I want you guys to know that the most important thing is to scrub two times a week or three times a week or two times. Do not press your face. This is the normal regime beauty care. First you have to, don't forget sunblock. It's very, very important, sunblock. And then, but every day you have to wash your face in a two different ways. First, makeup remover, smother over your face, and then wash it with warm water. And then after that, then you start with your cleanser, bueto, the bubbles around your face, and with cold water. And then you wear whatever you want to use. I'm not going to tell you what I'm going to use. I'm going to show you my progress in November, if not earlier. Okay, so I'm challenging you guys, whatever you want to choose to be in life, that you're moving, at least, if you do not achieve, like, you want to be a millionaire, of course, you're not going to achieve, maybe, who knows, you might achieve it. But if you haven't achieved in 2017, this year, I want to see at least a progress, like, I'm moving towards it, not sitting and waiting, it comes, like, you know, suddenly, no, right? You are progressing. Like, I want to know from you guys down below, and I will see you guys from time to time. But the total limit is I want to be at least slim and looking, you know, good and feel good by November. I'll see you guys there. I challenge you and you challenge me back. All right. I'm Alfie here. I love you guys so very much. Thank you for watching. And then I'm also a counselor, so you can write down anything you want down there. I'll see you guys.